Hi guys, welcome to the PageFly video tutorial series. In today's video, you'll learn how to structure your page with the layout element on PageFly. The layout element includes section, rows, and columns, which are at the very core of how PageFly structures pages. You can use the layout element to create your initial structure in sections, rows, and columns, before filling it with other elements on PageFly. The layout element helps you to position text, images, and all other page elements to have the best visual impact. The layout element is the first element you'll see when you come to your PageFly page, and in the top left corner click on Add Element. You'll see here that under Layouts there's 10 pre-built column layouts for you to start with, and you can easily add more containers if you want. So I'm just going to start up here with a full section. I'm going to drag and drop that onto my page. So a section holds the content of your page. PageFly arranges content by section so as to keep everything organized. Note that if you try and add another section, you cannot add it to the same section. You can only add it above or below. A section includes one or more rows which help structure your content further. You can add more rows inside your section by coming to the General tab of your section and simply clicking on Add Row. You can then click the first icon in the row to duplicate the row, like this, or click the icon next to it to delete one. You can also reorder the rows in the section by dragging the row where you want to put it. You can also customize the width of the section with the Set Fixed Width option. When disabled, the content in this section will expand to the full section's width. And then if you go to the Styling tab of your section, you can adjust parameters like the content color, the spacing with the padding in the margin, all the typography of the section, and the background. So there are three options for background style here: Standard, Video, and Parallax. We have a separate video about how to use the parallax option, and there's a URL link to that in the description of this video. Okay, so now we'll move on to rows. So just as a section includes one or more rows, a row includes one or more columns. Similarly, you can add columns to a row via the General tab. If you click on the row, come to its General tab, and at the top you can add column. Again, you can duplicate columns the same way as you can with rows by clicking on this button. And you can delete them the same way by clicking on this one. You can also add more columns by clicking on a column in the row and clicking on the plus button here. If you come to the row in the breadcrumb menu here, you have options in the General tab for your columns. Right now I have 5 columns in my row and all of their widths are unequal. So if I turn on the Enable Equal Width option just here, all of my columns will have equal width. You can also set how many columns you want per line with this slider option down here, which you can drag between 1 and the amount of columns you have. So if we come down here to column spacing, we can change the spacing between the columns with this slider. Again, we have another more detailed video about this, and the link for that is in the description of this video. Again, if we want to change anything to do with the styling of the row, we simply come to the Styling tab and choose anything in the parameters here. Okay, so finally I'm going to show you how a column works. So if we want to put any elements onto our page, we have to do it through a column. So first of all, I'm going to put a heading in my middle column here. Then I'm going to put an image in this column. And I'll put another image in this column. If you want to add any elements like these onto your page directly, then you simply come to Add Elements. And you can drag and drop, and that element will be automatically contained within a column, a row, and a section. If you want to see the overall page structure of your page, simply come down here and click on Show Page Outline. This will show you the sections that you already have on your page. You can also add any of these pre-built column layouts onto your page to save you time. So I'll just show you a few different ones here. Okay, and if I head to mobile view, you'll see that the elements structured from left to right on desktop view are structured from top to bottom on mobile view. Okay, so that's the end of the tutorial. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel for more helpful future content. Don't forget to leave us any questions in the comment section below or reach us via our 24/7 in-app live chat for further assistance. To learn more about PageFly, check out our other video tutorials and visit our help center. Thanks for watching. See you next time.